Hey everybody, welcome back to All By The Popcorn. My name is Stephanie. Thank you all for clicking on this video. If you're someone who enjoys talking about film, how about clicking that subscribe button? So today we're going to be talking about Barb and Star, Go to Vista Del Mar. Barb and Star is a PG-13 comedy. It was released on video on demand February the 12th. It starred Kristen Wiig, Annie Mamolo, and Jamie Dornan. I hope I said the names right. Kristen and Annie actually wrote the screenplay for this movie. They're the same people that wrote Bridesmaids. Now, with that said, don't go in to this movie expecting Bridesmaids, because it's nowhere near that level, but it is still a really good fun time. I knew absolutely nothing about this movie going in. So in Barb and Star, we are following lifelong friends who have worked together, who live together, and they finally decide to leave their small town because certain circumstances that happen in their life that now kind of permits them to go out and explore. And they finally go on a vacation outside of their small town. Where else will these women go to vacation but lovely Florida? But we don't only get that story, you guys. It is a very strange movie. We also have like another little kind of subplot with it, which honestly the movie could have done without, to be honest with you. We could have just focused on Barb and Star and kind of what they're going through and just kind of the romance that kind of comes up with it. The way that Jamie's character was introduced could have been slightly different, and I feel like a lot of the things that were still happening could have happened without that villain subplot that we ended up getting. Now, Kristen and Amy as Barb and Star, of course, have great on-screen chemistry. You could totally believe that these are lifelong friends. Now, I would have been a little concerned if that was not captured on camera, seeing that they have been friends for a little bit over a decade. It has really no real direction. The story's all over the place. I know, you guys, I know. It's ridiculous. Don't come at me in the comments about how stupid and lame and terrible. You guys, I know, but somehow it works. And I love it because it's my cup of tea. It's like they made this movie for me and for my sister. Like, this is like, we are the target audience. We are simple people that just laugh at pretty much everything. I don't care. You guys can judge us if you want. It is what it is. Like I said it before, comedy is my favorite type of movies. I love, love, love to laugh. So I will always choose a comedy over pretty much anything. I'm not gonna say much more about this movie, you guys. Before I give you my overall thoughts and my score, if you haven't already, go ahead and give this video a like. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet. Don't forget to hit the notification bell so you'll be notified each time that I post something new. I am trying to hit 500 subscribers before the summer, so hopefully you can help me achieve that goal. Now, Barb and Star Go to Vista Del Mar is a weird movie in its own way. It's hilarious. Like, I literally laughed a lot, you guys. It's wacky, it's quirky, it's silly, it's fun. We get a little bit of adventure, we get a little bit of love and romance, we got villains, well, we got a villain, a weird villain that we really didn't need, we got a lair, we got spontaneous musical numbers, we got Jamie Dornan just like Mr. Gray, why? But I was here for it. I was totally, totally here for it. Honestly, from the four movies that I saw this weekend, this one's my favorite. If you've seen Barb and Mar, Go to Vista Del Mar, let me know down below, what did you guys think about it? Did you like it? Did you love it? Did you hate it? Was it just not for you? Had you even heard of this movie before? With all that said, I'm gonna give Barb and Mar, Go to Vista Del Mar a medium popcorn. Some of you are probably thinking I was gonna give it a large, so I was thinking about it. I know how ridiculous it is, and no, I'm not gonna do that. Especially after I gave Judas a medium popcorn as well. Some of you were like, I can't believe you're putting Judas and the Black Messiah within this same ranking. Yes, I am, because it kind of falls. My ranking system is weird, you guys. It just, it so much falls within my popcorn sizes. That's it. Alright, you guys. Until next time, I'll see you guys at concessions. Bye.